Last year, scores of U.S. families were created as American parents went overseas to adopt. This is one story we're calling From Russia with Love.
I had always wanted children, and I, at some point, I think I said, well, if I, by the time I'm 40, I'm not married yet, I'm going to do it on my own. I was doing well, I was happy, I felt good, I still didn't have a guy in my life, and I was approaching 40.
Good girl.
And I said, I'm ready.
Nicole Sandler wanted a baby so badly that she was willing to explore every option.
So I immediately, that night, I got on the computer and I looked up international adoption. I for some reason, was just being drawn to Russia. My heritage is Russian.
It took an emotional year and a half of bureaucracy and broken promises to find a baby.
That year was very, very tough because it was a lot of, oh, you'll have a referral like within a month. Oh, it'll be, you know, soon. I get a call saying there are no healthy girls in Chelyabinsk. But there's a little girl in Kazakhstan we think you might be interested in. And I woke up in the morning to an email with this precious little girl that was like all eyes, and I just, my stomach flip-flopped, and I just went, oh my God, that's her. First thought is, she's absolutely precious. Second thought is, oh my God, she's so tiny, and at 15 months old, look, she can't even stand, and she's so stiff. You know, I just wanted to take her and feed her and hold her. I mean, I immediately fell in love with her.
Found abandoned on the street when she was just a month old, an orphanage took her in and gave her a name.
Her name is Michael here, but in America, her name will be Alison.
Nicole traveled to Kazakhstan to bring home her new daughter, and she recorded the experience.
It made your eyes look so funny. I wasn't, you know, going to put on makeup because I hate wearing makeup, but I thought, I'm meeting my daughter for the first time.
Oh, there it's yours. Oh, my God.
Oh, look at those eyes.
The little girl I got was 18 months old when I met her, but in many ways she was a baby, not a toddler. She weighed maybe 16 or 17 pounds.
I need a kiss.
So it was like scary in that sense. I was nervous about meeting her, just hoping she would, you know, take to me as much as me taking to her.
You say, do svidaniya, Aliya. Do svidaniya, Aliya. You come home with me. We start our new life together, okay?
A new start in a new country. Alison and Nicole had to figure out how to become a family.
I have to believe that she was going through some period of mourning. I mean, here I am, a person that she had only known for a few days. I visited her for a few hours for 3 days. And then I took her away from all the people that she knew that were taking care of her and that were loving her.
Where are these pictures from? These pictures are from Kazakhstan. Right. These are from a local artist in Kazakhstan. That's where Alison was born. For some reason, you wound up all the way on the other side of the world, and Mommy had to go on an airplane and find you and bring you home.
Okay.
Okay. You want a bite of this? You want a strawberry?
Nicole also had to deal with some of the simplest things we all take for granted.
She didn't get enough to eat in the orphanage. You know, they didn't have enough to feed them. So she'd eat everything and inhale it all. And now she's starting to say no to things and pushes food away before her plate is clean. And, you know, I think I'm the opposite of most parents because I was thrilled when she started doing that.
No.
In the orphanage, they said they bathed the children once a week, but they weren't actually baths, they were sponge baths. They got a sponge bath once a week. These kids had never been immersed in a tub of water. You know, that first night, I went to take her in the bath, and you would have thought I was putting her in a pot of boiling water. She screamed. Bath time over there, if they had real baths, was never pleasurable. It wasn't a fun thing. It was torture. So, you know, when they realize that it's fun here, you know, they all wind up loving it. Like, she loves the bath. It's a fun play area. Right? Right.
While Allison's first language is Russian, communication has not been a problem.
For a child from a bilingual household, which technically she is because she never heard English till she was 18 months old, she's ahead of where she should be.
Oh, knock, knock. Who's there? It's Maisie. There she is.
Well, I've never given birth, so I don't know what that feels like or what that bond feels like, but I know that there's no way a mother-daughter bond could be stronger or that I could possibly love a child more than I love Allison. Adoptive parents have a saying that, you know, you grew in somebody else's womb, but you grew in my heart. She absolutely did. It doesn't matter where she came from. I love her more than I ever knew I could love anybody else.
How much does Mama love Allison?
And more and more and more and more and more and more and more.
I don't think she has to worry that she didn't give birth. You can tell they've got a bond. Way to go, Nicole. According to Nicole, the lack of money is really the hardest part about raising a child alone. Well, you'll be glad to know she's got a new job. So she and Allison are moving to New Mexico for a better life. Is adopting internationally an option for you? We're going to talk about that and how the events of September 11th have affected adoption all over the world. You're watching Pure Oxygen. We'll be right back.